The difference between how GPS satellites measure time and how we measure time on Earth through rotations of the planet. So GPS satellites, being self-contained systems that are orbiting the Earth, use atomic clocks to measure their time. And GPS time has its own epoch, which I believe started in the year 1980. This is opposed to coordinated universal time, which we use here on Earth, which is based on the rotation of the Earth around the Sun and then rotation of the Earth around its own axis each day. So as we may be aware, the Earth is continually slowing down, but the rate that it slows down is different based on different geological and environmental and climate factors. So every few years, we have to add a leap second in between GPS time and UTC time. And basically what this means ultimately is that when we get a GPS time measurement from our IMU, that's, you know, talking to our GPS satellites up in space, we have to subtract a certain number of leap seconds from that measurement when converting to UTC time. And this is important so that all of our data from our sensors can be synchronous in time, because we use UTC time in our stack. We don't use GPS time. So moving on to the next slide. I just wanted to go over a quick kind of, this is pulled from one of our utilities here at Civil Maps, where we convert from UTC to GPS time. And as an input to this function, this is in C++, we have the week as an integer and the seconds as a double. And basically, GPS time is measured by the number of weeks since January 1, 1980, I believe, and the number of seconds within that week. So using those two measurements of week and second, you can get an exact moment in time. So we support data up to the year, up to and beyond the year 2008, primarily because our company is not older than 2008, and we have not had the need for any data prior to that, but we definitely can add it to this function, and we have lots of data going back at least a few years now. And pretty much what this function does is it looks up the week that we're inputting here, and again, this is the number of weeks since 1980. Based on that week, we can estimate, or we know for that matter, the year that we're in. Given that, then we know the number of leap seconds that we need to subtract. This past January, an additional leap second was actually added, so now there's 18 leap seconds between GPS satellites and UTC time. And then from there, we basically just return a simple formula, or the result of a simple formula, which is the week that we got as an input here, multiplied by the number of seconds in a week, which is 604,800 seconds, plus the number of seconds that we got as our input to the second input to the function, as well as the difference, which I believe is almost exactly 10 years, between the UTC epoch and the GPS epoch, which is this number of seconds, and ultimately we then subtract the leap second that we compute here using our week. So it's a pretty simple conversion from GPS to UTC time, but it is definitely a very crucial one when you are trying to make all of your data synchronous in time, and particularly play back that data after you've already collected it.
Yes.